acknowledge him, and he shall direct your path. And that is Proverbs 3, 5, and 6. Join us as we go into prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, we come to you right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, we come thanking you, O God, for your many blessings. We thank you, O God, because you are the one and only living and true God. And Lord, we come to give you glory and honor and praise, O God, because of who you are and all that you have done in each and every one of our lives. Lord, we come to you right now in the name of Jesus. We come to you, O God, thanking you for bringing us through another year, O God, allowing us to see this new year. Oh God, we thank you, oh God, for this day. For this is the day that you have made, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it. And Lord, we magnify and praise your holy name, God. We lift you up, hallelujah. And Lord, we give you the highest praise, hallelujah. But Lord, we can't thank you enough, oh God. We just said thank you because you are worthy. You are worthy, oh God. And there's nobody like you, Lord. Can't nobody do us like you, hallelujah. And Lord, we said thank you, hallelujah. Lord, we thank you for keeping us, oh God. We thank you, oh God, for giving us strength. Lord, we thank you for giving us peace, oh God. We thank you for placing joy in our hearts in the name of Jesus. And Lord, we ask you to continue to just take us through, oh God, as we go through this journey of life here on earth. Then Lord, we ask you to just lead us and guide us in your righteousness, oh God. Help us, oh God, to read and to study your word, oh God, in the name of Jesus. And Lord, we ask you to just save and deliver. We ask you to set free, God, and heal in the name of Jesus. Lord, we look to you to heal from all manner of diseases and sicknesses, oh God. Lord, we ask you to just continue to deliver and heal from this pandemic that we've been going through, oh God. Lord, we ask you to just touch the minds and touch the bodies of people everywhere, all over the world, in the name of Jesus. Lord, that you be lifted up, that you be glorified, in the name of Jesus, that people will continue to know that you are the great physician, that you are the healer that we need, that you are everything that we need. Oh God, we thank you, Lord, for we know that everything that we need is in you. And Lord, it is in you that we live, that we move, and that we have our being. And Lord, for that we are grateful, oh God. Lord, we thank you, we praise you, God. Lord, we worship you and we honor you.
Oh, Welcome to Jerusalem Temple, Church of God in Christ, located at 12 Elizabeth Road in the city of Leland, Mississippi, where our pastor is the Superintendent Roy Riley Sr. and our First Lady is First Lady Mazel Riley. Our motto is that we must decrease so that God can increase. We want to thank you for watching our service. Certainly, if you were blessed by the Word of God, please like, share, and subscribe to our YouTube and Facebook channels. Also, to be a blessing to the ministry, you may do so by one of the following ways. Through Givelify, Jerusalem Temple Church of God in Christ in Leland, Mississippi. Through PayPal at jtcogic@att.net. You may also use Cash App, $Jerusalem Temple. Or you may mail your check or money order to P.O. Box 329, Leland, Mississippi 38756. God's richest blessing be upon you.
happen to come into your homes today, wherever you may be, observing this telecast, certainly the Lord has been good to us. He has been blessing us day by day, down through the year. The Lord has kept us. And I'm certainly glad that we have entered into a new year. God has certainly blessed us all of last year's during this pandemic and other trials and problems that one may have had. It has been God that brought us through. Just a word of prayer with you at this time. Lord Jesus, we thank you, oh God. We thank you for all of your blessings. Thank you for keeping us. Thank you for watching over us. We thank you, Lord, for bringing us through the year of 2020. Thank you for your hand of deliverance. Many, I know, have passed away during that year, but yet you kept us here for some reason or the other, and we are grateful to you. We are thankful, oh God, and we pray that you would continue to bless this people, bless our country, and that you would be a blessing to the entire world. Keep us in your care, oh God, in Jesus' name, thank God. Amen and amen. Certainly we thank God for you on this Lord's Day. And again, we are very thankful for how the Lord has kept us. Has kept us down through last year and enabled us to enter into what we call the new year. We are grateful. Many of our loved ones and many others that we didn't know did not make it to this year, but we are here. I'm going to go quickly to the word of the Lord. One verse in the book of the Colossians, chapter 1 and verse 16. You've heard this, no doubt, read many times, but I'm impressed to read it again. For by him were all things created, that are in heaven and in the earth, the visible, the invisible, whether they be thrones or dominions or principalities or power. All things were created by him and for him. Praise the Lord. All things were created by him and for him. And I want to use for a subject today, why am I here? And that's a question that I would like for you to think about and personally ask yourself, why am I here? Why am I in this world? The Bible said again that all things were created by him and for him. Now, even the person that we know as Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, existed as an equal member of the Godhead from all eternity. In other words, Jesus Christ was in all eternity with the Father and the Holy Ghost, or part of the Godhead. And that was before he became the Son of God, before he became the Son of God. You see, sonship refers to his humanity, not to his deity. Sonship only refers to his humanity. When he came to this earth, born of the Virgin Mary. He was came as a human being. And therefore, praise the Lord, to give us an example, he did not use any divine power, but he always prayed to the Father. He was human on this earth. And at the same time, he was divine also. He was a spirit being carried out. He was that spirit that carried out the divinity. He carried out the creation of everything. That creation of everything, the Son carried it out. Now, if you think about it and look at why we are here, another year has already closed out. Another year is already gone. A new year has begun. The changing of one's year to another year, it should make us think about time and about, really, why am I here? You know, we are doing many things in this life, and people are doing as they so desire. They're going their own way and doing their own thing. But the question again, why are we here? You see, you were born to please God. You were born to live for God and for God's purpose. And the purpose of your life is greater. The purpose of your life is greater than just for your happiness or your family or even your dreams and ambition. Now, if you really want to know why you were placed on earth, you have to begin with God. You know, because if you see, there are many things that are invented by man. And you see, we would not know how to use them unless we got some instructions from the inventor or the manual that goes with the invention. You would not know how to use it because you are not the inventor. You see, God made all of us. He made the entire, all of humanity and everything that there is. But I want to let you know that you were born by his purpose and for his purpose. Many people have been trying to find out now just why am I here? That's a question it seems that all many people have asked themselves. What's my reason? They ask questions like, what are my goals? What are my goals? My ambition? What do I want to be? What are my dreams for the future? So a lot of people are dreaming for the future, but what are my dreams for the future? And therefore, but when you focus on yourselves, and you can't reveal, or you will never reveal your life purpose. The Bible says that it is God who directs our lives, the lives of his creatures. It is God who directs us. And therefore, praise the Lord, everyone's life is in his power. Contrary to what many popular books and movies and seminars tell you, regardless as to what they tell you, people are going to many things, maybe trying to find an answer. But you won't discover your life meaning by looking within yourselves. Now some people say, look within yourself. Hallelujah. You see, you didn't create yourself. So there's no way that you can tell yourself what you were created for. And I want to tell you, you cannot arrive at your life purpose by starting and focusing on yourself. You must begin with God the Creator. You exist really because God willed that you exist. Not only that, praise the Lord, but you were made by God and for God. And people don't understand that. Many don't understand. They feel that I'm here to have a good time, to do as I please, to go where I want to go, and to be what I want to be. But until you understand that you were really made by God and for God, life will never make real sense. It is only in God that we discover our origin. We discover our origin, our identity. We discover our meaning, our purpose, and also our significance. And we lastly discover our destiny. It is only in God. Every other path leads to a dead end. It's a dead end it leads to. You were made for God and not vice versa. And life is about letting God use you for his purpose. If we understand, let God use us for his purpose, not for really our own purpose. Hallelujah. Not using him and using God for your own purpose, but God, let him use us for his purpose. You know, there are many books that are written, have been written, and they suggest ways of discovering the purpose of your life. Many books are written, and they usually refer to the same steps. These books, they usually have the same steps. And those steps are finding your life purpose. For finding that purpose, many times seminars and books that you read will tell you, consider your dreams. Clarify your values. Set some goals. Figure out what you are good at. Figure out what are you good at. Aim high and then go for it. Be disciplined. Believe that you can achieve your goals and then involve others in it. But never give up. Now listen, these recommendations, they may often lead to success. You can usually succeed in reaching a goal if you put your mind to it. But being successful and fulfilling your life purpose are not at all the same issue. You may reach all of your personal goals. You may reach all of them that you set out to do. You may be a rolling success as far as the world is concerned, according to the world's standards, and still you miss the purpose for what God created you for. Hallelujah. You see, a life that's devoted to things is really a dead life. But God, hallelujah, if you would take on the life that's being shaped by God, then of course you will have a flourishing life. The Bible said, blessed are those who trust in the Lord. In other words, your confidence, your trust, your hope is in the Lord God. Therefore, you can be or you will be like a tree that's planted along the riverbanks. And that tree, its roots deep, go deep down into the ground. deep into the water. And such trees, they're not bothered by the heat. They're not worried by the long months of drought. Because, praise the Lord, they're anchored in a safety place and their roots go deep in the ground where the water is. But I want to tell you, some people feel that life is not worth living. Life is not worth living. I'm having so much trouble and difficulties and problems, praise the Lord. And I wish I had never been born. But I want to tell you, you are not an accident. You are not an accident. Your birth was no mistake. It was no mistake or mishap. Well, your life is not a fluke of nature. Some people feel that way, but your life is not a fluke of nature. Your parents may not even plan you, but God did. He was not at all surprised at your birth. In fact, he expected it. Long before you were conceived by your parents, you were conceived in the mind of God. Long before your parents were conceived, you are alive because God wanted to create you. God prescribed every single detail of your body. He deliberately described every single detail of your body. He deliberately chose your race. He chose the color of your skin, your hair, and every other feature that you may have. God is the one that chose it. And some people, they seem to have a problem even with their race. Some have even said, I wish I had been born in another race. I wish I had certain things, but God deliberately chose your race for you. The color of your hair, the texture of your skin, the color of your skin, and every other feature in you, he custom made you just the way he wanted you to be. He also determined your natural talents. We look at people, we say talented people, but God gave all of us a talent, huh? Praise the Lord. And so we look at others and we wish other things sometime. Hallelujah. But the talent, the natural talent that you would possess and the uniqueness of your personality, it was all in the hands of God. The Bible said that you know me, God, you know me inside and out. You know every bone in my body. You know exactly how that I was made. God knows all about us, huh? He knows everything about us. And because God made you for a reason. He also decided where you would be born. Hallelujah. And how long you would live. He planned the days of your life in advance. That is, choosing the exact time that you would be born and when you would die. Not only that, but the Bible says that in the book of Psalms, that is Psalms 129, beginning about at the fifth verse, the Bible said that And the psalmist said this about God, my substance was not hid from thee when I was made in secret. My substance was not hid from thee. And what about that substance? Praise the Lord. When your mother and father came together, and when the egg was fertilized by the sperm, scientists call that substance then, a zygote. Life began. A zygote there. And the Bible said in that 139th number of Psalms, and you curiously wrought, I was curiously wrought in the lowest part of the earth. The 16th verse says, thine eyes did see my substance. Lord, you saw my substance. Yet being unperfect, and in thy book all of my members then were recorded, which in continuous were fashioned, when as yet there was none of them. The psalmist said, Lord, you saw when I was just a fertilized egg. And you saw then, hallelujah, you saw how I would continue to develop. You saw that I was unperfect then. And even at that stage, the psalmist said, all of my members were written in your book. Not only that, but how they would progress and continue and how they were fashioned, yet when there was none of them, you saw it and you knew. So many of us have been here a long time that we think. Our years, some of us have gotten way up in age and some may have reached 100 years of age and never thought, hallelujah, I was born, I was created, or why am I here? Been going your own way for so long, doing your own thing for so long, you just have, hallelujah, not even thought about your being here and why you are here. Hallelujah. For the Bible said, Lord, you created all things. You created them for your pleasure and for your goodness. Praise the Lord for your creation, your pleasure, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You have made all things. Therefore, praise the Lord, because God made you for a reason. He also decided where you would be born and how long you would live. He planned the days of your life in advance, choosing the exact time of birth and death. Hallelujah. You see, our bounds are appointed by God. Hallelujah. And we cannot pass our bounds, huh? He planned the days of your life in advance. He planned them all. The Bible said he saw us. Praise the Lord. He saw us and he knew all about us. Praise the Lord. You saw me when I was born and you scheduled the days of my life before I began to breathe. And every day is revealed in your book. Hallelujah. God also planned where we would be born and where you would live for his purpose. Your race and all of that, God planned it. Hallelujah. Can you just tell God thank you? Come on, tell the Lord thank you, everybody. Hallelujah. You find out that many children, hallelujah, they were unplanned. And their parents, praise the Lord, they were unplanned by their parents, but they were planned by God. Hallelujah. God never makes a mistake, huh? He never makes a mistake. He's always, praise the Lord, right in what he does. He's a perfect God, absolutely perfect, no flaws, never makes a mistake. And not only that, praise the Lord, but after he made and created man, after he made us, hallelujah, he didn't make any accidents, huh? Praise the Lord, never a mistake. And he has a reason for everything he created. Even for the every plant, every animal, it was planned by God. Every person was designed with a purpose in his mind. God's motive for creating you was his love. The word said, for God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten son, hallelujah, that died for the sins of humanity. The Bible said long before he laid the foundation of the earth, he had us in mind. He had settled us on his focus. We were in his mind. He loved us so even before we were created. Hallelujah. And God was thinking of you even before he made the world. In fact, that's why he created the world. Hallelujah. And I tell you, praise the Lord, after he had made the world, he created man. After he had made the world and the things that are in the world, he created man. Therefore, the purpose of your life is far greater than your personal fulfillment. It is far greater. It's greater than your peace of mind or your happiness. It's greater than your family or your career or even your wildest dream and ambition. And the Bible said in Revelation, the 4th chapter, verse 11, it stated that thou art worthy, O Lord, to receive glory, to receive power, to receive honor. For thou hast created all things, and for thy pleasure they were and are created. Hallelujah. Now, what drives you today? Is it your dream? Your ambition? What is the purpose of your life? What do you feel that the purpose of your life is? But I want to say, praise the Lord, it's time to realize, hallelujah, and think about self. Because when God made us, he made us to please him. He made us to live a righteous life. He made us to live a holy life. Hallelujah. And therefore we were made in his image and after his likeness. Therefore, when we look at this God, this creator of all things, therefore, praise the Lord, we are to please him. Please him by the way we live. And I'm afraid that too many that have forgotten or never known, but it's time to know. Hallelujah. We look at this pandemic. That was all of the most of last year. Hallelujah. Most of all of last year. And still is with us today. Praise the Lord. And we don't know how long. We don't know how long it will be. But when you look at the plague that happened in 1919 through 1918, there were 20 million people that died. 20 million people. If we look at the statistics from this virus of last year and this year, only, and I say only, 1 million and about approximately 1,900,000 people have lost their lives in that plague that they feel that died from the plague. But just think about 20 million people starting in 1918 through 1919. More people lost their lives from that plague than in all of World War I, people that lost their lives. In World War I, more people lost their lives. But God has blessed us in the midst of this pandemic. Hallelujah. God has kept us. Those of you who are alive, maybe, praise the Lord, God was trying to really tell you something. God was trying to really maybe, he allowed you to be awakened up and really come to yourself and look where you are and where you could be. Hallelujah. I tell you, it's time to surrender to him and say, Lord, here I am. Hallelujah. And I believe in your son Jesus and let God do a work in your life. Hallelujah. So many need healing. So many need deliverance from self. So many need deliverance from things of the past. Hallelujah. Things that they're still suffering with. they're still having trouble with, problems with. Hallelujah. You have to let God deliver you. Let the Holy Ghost abide and deliver you. So many, praise the Lord, come up, came up with hatred within their hearts. Maybe as to what someone did to them. Hallelujah. Someone misused them. Family member misused them. Hallelujah. So many things that one may be talking and thinking about, and letting that block out, hallelujah, a knowledge of God and what God want to do in your life and how God want to use you. Use you for his purpose and for his will. It's time to realize, hallelujah, he so loves us. He so loved this world. So it's time, praise the Lord, to think, my life, what is my life? Hallelujah. Why and know why God made you. Begin with the Creator himself. Hallelujah. Seek his will. Seek his way. Seek his word. And turn from every evil way. Because this world is doomed. Hallelujah. Humanity is doomed. Hallelujah. Accept God. Hallelujah. Except you allow him to come into your life. Hallelujah. Can you just tell him thank you? Hallelujah. Just tell, wherever you are, just tell him thank you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And just decide and just come to him and just surrender to him. And he will make something. He will make great things. Things that he had even planned for you. And greatness is not to praise the Lord because of how much money one has or how many material things one may acquire, praise the Lord, or how much success one think that he has occurred and has received. But praise the Lord, to lose your soul is the worst of all. To lose one's soul. Hallelujah. But let's think this year, beginning with this year, let's think. God, hallelujah. I tell you, if you could just go to him in prayer, in earnest, seeking him. Lord, why did you make me? Hallelujah. Lord, what is my purpose? Hallelujah. When you first give your life to him, hallelujah. You feel his presence. You know that he's come in. And you say, Lord, why? What is my reason for being here? What do you want me to do? And I tell you, this life will soon be over. And we'll have to spend eternity somewhere. Either with the Lord or in hell. People don't like for you to use the word hell. But it's a reality. And God bless you today. God keep you today, and certainly just give yourself and your life to him and let him have his way for the reason for making us today. We're thankful. Thank God for you today. We're praying for you. We want you to keep looking up. Keep tuned into these services. God bless you and keep you.
Can it solve?